is I, Mephidian, who joins you here at Fort Uruk in Volskar. We rescued Yama and Nilhard in the previous part. And, ooh, I've got a ton of frame rate lag there for some reason. Lydia's up there, that's good. Let's just get down and... No, let's not get down. Let's just go ahead and unlock this bridge. I take a lever, it doesn't even move now, which is funny. Because I know it did in the previous version. It moved. So let's exit out of Fort Uruk. Nothing being thrown about, is there? Nope. They're all patiently waiting for me, how nice. And let's see what we find. I'm just going to recast this just to make sure that it's in place. Let's rush out over here and find out what's going on.
Agnar, what are you doing?
And I can't
here?
Move either, which is a pain.
Oh, of course. Flocking to help the people.
Oh, really? You know these imbokas.
I don't see Colgrim anywhere. He was about as competent as a chicken fighting a pack of wolves.
So basically, you're insulting your lieutenants, okay?
You and me, Ingvar. Let my family and friends go.
Oh, but it really isn't. You asked for help from Thorlok and the Hjorgunners.
Ingvar wants to take the long way around by circling his guard.
If you die in this war,
I love that.
It's all on you.
Don't listen to him, Agnar.
Does he really still have you two wrapped around his finger? How long are you going to let him pull your strings, And what about your friend here, the prophetic traveler? They aren't even a Nord, yet they fight for you. Fools. I tell you what. I'll let your friends and family go.
Now why would you want to give up the keys? That's just stupid. We went to a lot of effort to get these keys.
No!
Why would you give them up?
Don't do it, Agnar.
You, on the other hand, I will not let go. You've orchestrated all of this. You have caused me far too much trouble.
Don't, Agnar. He won't let us go.
He is not a man.
Of course he's not going to be a man of his word. He's the villain.
I have no choice.
Yes, you do have a choice.
Just know this,
Ingvar. Don't give him the keys. If you do, it just fucks up the storyline.
But it will only be your undoing. My people will keep fighting in my stead. In my memory.
If you say so.
Do you know why? It's because as their leader, I serve them.
Good for you.
A king is only as strong as his loyalty towards his people.
If you say so.
You lie and trick your people. You are not a king. You are not worthy of the throne to Valskar.
If you say so again.
Help my people.
Stop giving us all the... He's very good at the verbal stuff. He does a lot of talking, very little action.
But above all, I defend them. I fought for them. And they will do the same for me.
There has to be another way.
Yes, of course there has to be another way.
Oh, trust me. There is no other
Yes, there
way.
Is every other way. You fucking idiot!
Thank you, Agnar. I'll be going now. Goodbye. Kill all of them.
Asshole!
You bastard!
Yes, you are a bastard.
We had a deal.
Why is he ever gonna keep up his deals, Agnar? You were just tricked into giving up the keys. Idiot. We're going to attack you. Oh, that went down in one hit. That was nice. Oh, he's got some decent armor. I'm not taking that though. There's a lot of dots around here, but they're pretty weak. Oh, sorry, Sveagard, I didn't mean to hit you. That's a full guard. There's an elite guard. I can't really do much here because of my flame action. I just want them to just both dissipate. Really. Ow. The hell is hitting me. Let's just try over here. One hit. With a weak bow. I'll just quickly heal up. I don't have any flame action tonight to do any heavy damage, which is good. Oh, that was Barlow, I take it. Die. And they're all pretty weak now, which is good. Is that it? I think so. I think I just have to go and speak to Agnar or something, or he's probably talking as we stand here. What the hell is that body gone? It doesn't matter. There was never an enemy, but I didn't see it until just there. Just take the useful loot. Let's see. Yeah, I'm just going to take a lot of this sort of semi-useful loot that I could use for smithing or selling. I could do both. If there's another enemy around here, then I'm not aware of any. Where the hell is everyone going? Why the hell are we still in battle? They must be running off to someone. I'll just lead them to it then, I take it. One of them must have fallen down or something. Look at this nice peak. Oh, there's certainly one down there. But where? I'll have to lead them to battle it out. Might as well just fall down there just to... I'll just kind of fall down these cliffs to try and find out where this last enemy is. Ah, here we go. I get the killing blow. Yeah, you're speaking, I don't care.
Ingvar has all five keys and probably knows where the heart is.
Yeah, and you basically gave him the keys to allow that to happen. You're a fucking cunt, Agnar. You shouldn't have been giving up the keys at all.
Once and for all. Meet me back in Amber Creek. On the way there, Ulgar, Sveagard, Thorlo, and I will make a plan as to how we should go about doing this.
Well,
I'll give you more information once we are back at Amber Creek.
Honestly, in my opinion, you would be in this state if you hadn't went and given up the keys in the first place. What idiot. And it's an elven arrow I'll just take, I'll just stop that splashing movement. Yeah, speak with Agnar once he arrives back in Amber Creek. Good for him. Destruction's up to 53, that's good. It's going to take us for bloody ever to get to level 42 in my opinion. Because we're barely leveling up in these skills and these guys are just going to walk back sedately. Without any rush at all. Okay. It's not like we've got to, you know, stop Ingvar. I mean, that doesn't matter apparently. Let's take some more loot. It's good to take the loot. I think there was a guard over here, wasn't there? There was a bunch of blood here. Apparently I can't find him. Oh well, let's just go back to Amber Creek and see if they're back, which they're not, as far as I can understand it. Nope, they're still away over here, so let's actually, I think these boys are still around, the dead bandit bodies. No, they've all been cleared up. Apparently, which is a shame. So presumably this bandit here that we can't search, well, the we can't search and has nothing on it. None of the other bandits are around, which is a shame. But let's just wait for Figgy to come back. And he's back. I simply decided to cut out that wait just to save 5 seconds of time, just to try and get rid of all the loading screen crap, but they're back. Yama's got a sword for no reason. Well, I hope that they have a plan, because it'd be funny if they didn't.
I still can't believe.
Don't care what's the plan.
I am gathering all of my forces, a fair-sized army. We are going to seize Stalgard. It lies on the far side of the Emerald.
So why the hell have we got to come all the way back here just to go all the way back to where we were? That was dumb.
Before we go there, we must prepare. In the meantime, we need the route into the valley cleared.
If
that's
you say
where
so.
You and Ulgar come in. Thorlo, Svegard and I will stay here and help prepare everything. You must go meet Ulgar at the base of the hill below the Emerald Valley gates.
Okay.
He will be waiting there with a small group of soldiers to help. Clear the path into the valley, and we can set up our attack camps. Just know that once we set up camp to attack, nobody's leaving until Ingvar is stopped.
I'm fully prepared, you don't need to worry about me. I'm a magicka user, I'm a mage, so I'd have the arcane at my disposal to keep me protected ad infinitum.
I must gather my war crest and say goodbye to my family.
You're not gonna die. That is just so pathetic.
I wish Ulgar would stop.
Well, I don't care, Svegard. Because you'll find that Ulgar is away over at the Emerald Valley. Doing God knows what. And of course, it's always night time over at this side, isn't it? It's boring. I don't know why I have to fast travel and it causes it to be night time. Say 50, that's boring. And I think there's some stuff that we can find around here in terms of locations, but maybe I'm wrong. I don't know why we have to have this long path up the hill. It'd be nice if there was something other than just a big long path with trees. It'd be a bit more interesting. But I like how everything is literally signposted. Northern Pass, I've already mentioned, the Northern Pass is going to have nothing in it forever until the community make a mod that overrides the master of that area. And then just maybe we might have something of meaningfulness over there. Because I think that the Northern Pass could have led to a really nice tundra area. But Velike has decided to stop mod work on Volskar, which is perfectly entitled to do. But it means that there's no more updates for Volskar, and whatever we've got here is what we just have to deal with. Never mind, Lydia will catch up soon in our heavy armor stuff. I'll have to make her a better mace or sword or summon to improve things there. Let's just give Lydia a chance to catch up by... Oh no, she's in distance, it's okay. I like how to get all the torches out, it's nice. Hello, Ulgar.
Ah, you're here. There's no time to waste, my friend. There's a small fort up the hill with a few men in it, and the camp farther down the path.
Okay.
Speak with me once we've cleared both areas, and you're ready to go.
Fine.
We'll let Hagenar know it's clear, and the troops can move in.
He could have said this all earlier before us having to be near him. So help clear the Emerald Valley gates. The obvious plan of attack, is it not? Now, what if this glitch with Ingvar being just up here is sorted? Hopefully it is, because if it's not, I'd be a bit pissed. I still don't understand why we've got to walk across a river to get up here. I don't actually know why we've got to zigzag around this bit to get up. I don't understand why it can't just be a straight line. It'd be so much better. Ah, no. Ingvar is still here. Hello.
I hope this changes your act.
Oh, it's called Emerald Soldiers, which is good. That's an Amber Creek soldier. I'm not sure where anyone is, so let's just these guys are actually very strong, I have to say. Whoops. Almost get killed here. Yeah, let's get on this. No, you're not gonna kill my Flamat track, you're going to die to my Flamat track, and yep. Quite a few enemies, they are very, very weak, I have to say. And I think we're getting a few Amber Creek guys dying as well, which is not too good. There's an Amber Creek soldier who has died. Fitted guard helmet, how nice. Not worth the gold, it's painted on million, to be honest with you. Got a skeleton with some gold, how nice. Wonder why there's some of that up here. Good for you. I'm just sort of going to leave this to be the way it is, and Lydia, don't get killed, for goodness sake. I like how Lydia's just kind of standing there getting all this happening to her. Well, Amber Creek soldiers have pretty much all died, which is great. I'm just going to search everyone's bodies for a little bit of loot, as they will say. The Emerald Soldiers had some decent loot on them in most cases, but the Amber Creek Soldiers are such a joke. I mean, they've just got some gold. Not even worth searching, to be honest with you. I'm pretty sure there's some other loot that we can find around here. I'm getting it now because we can't come back up here because the gate gets closed for no apparent reason. So there is some loot in here that you can't get once you've gone through this bit. There should be a strong box around here, I guess there is. It's an apprentice locked one, but that's no match for my 67 lock picking skill. Decent amount of loot, some gems, stones, I think, yes. I like how there's a path that just leads to here and stops. They're pointless. I don't think there's anything else in the way of stuff. I'm actually just going to quickly take a look. This tower, just to make sure I've not missed anything. Nope, not missed anything, so there's nothing else worth looting here, it's just a loot, essentially. Don't see the point of that waterfall at all, but never mind. I hope I don't get any CTDs going into this battle, because that's happened before where I've had a CTD. I do like the pattern, there's a path, a river stream just running down the valley here. It's quite good. I think it really makes it decent up here, but my god, the distance that we have to go to get up here is crazy. And it feels as if you're going much slower for no apparent reason. Well, they've set up a camp. Now, I sort of like how Ulgar has rushed all the way up here and has basically done nothing about these two enemies who have just been here all this time. So what the hell's that about? No, I wasn't trying to speak to Ulgar God. So I am going to not quick save yet. I'm just going to talk to Thingy. I don't like how there's a gate that bars your way into this bit. And it's not like there's anything behind it, it's just a pre-set up sequence essentially. Which I find quite ridiculous, but never mind. We are going to.
Simple enough, right? Unfortunately, that's the easiest part of this whole damn mess that we've gotten ourselves into.
Yeah, thanks to Agnar.
Are you ready? Remember, once we begin the attack...
I don't actually understand why Velikae forced us into this.
Or we die.
I'm not sure why we can't have the choice to depart from the fight. I don't know why we had to be forced, but fine.
Very well. May we meet again after battle, or in Sovngarde.
Well, we're not going to be in Sovngarde, so don't brother. Worry. See you on the other side, then. There is another side. There was a loading screen there that was pretty much...
It
not even
the
a loading screen.
Cover,
We just get teleported to the other side of the gate.
What?
Whatever
surprised
it is.
Surprised to see me here? I am a guard and a soldier. I've got to help in this fight too, you know. Are you scared?
No, I'm not
scared. I'm sworn to protect this land and its people.
And Lydia's come to join us. So nice.
Nothing of this scale has ever happened to me. Then again, we've got Agar.
There's a gate around here. I'll go and have a look at after the battle, I suppose. Right. But you can't get back in here from this side once you've done this bit.
Your attention, please. They're ready for you, partner.
Thank you, Ulgar. Fair people of Valskar.
Have you just basically conscripted every person who isn't from Stalgard or something?
Allowed my family, the Borvaldurs, to lead you. Through thick and thin, you have worked hard, supported us, and provided unwavering loyalty. Unfortunately, not all who live in Valskar are content. The Yunvaldir see the throne as their birthright, and something that can be owned or taken. They have started war after war, seeking power, their greed unmatched.
If you say so, I like how he's kind of now in ago, new armor and all that.
To stop fighting and to accept peace.
Well, clearly that had no impression on them, didn't
However,
it?
Over the last few months, Ingvar Yunvaldir, Jarl of Stalgard,
I don't think Valskar really has Jarls. To be honest with you, it kind of makes no sense at all that he would have a Jarl. You might as well call them local rulers rather than Jarls, because Jarls are really kind of reserved for the main main Skyrim. No, he hasn't forced your hand. You had the choice to keep the keys and prevent him carrying out his plans. You could have killed him there and then. But instead, you're a fucking wimp and give him up the keys.
Return the favor, ending this once and for all.
If you say so. And fight your way. Quick save. I sort of like the battle track, but guessing out other. There's the gate. Okay, fine. So we're just on the other side of that and teleported to here. That's lovely. I don't like how there's a forced battle track for this. And these catapults are so pointless because I mean, what the hell do we have to start our way back here for? I mean, this is so stupid. Why have I got to run all this distance just to get to fucking Stalgard? And for no apparent reason, you'll notice that throughout most of this Let's Play, the Stalgard icon was greyed out and now suddenly it's become discovered, even though we haven't actually seen a discovered message. Which I think is rather ridiculous. Where the hell did those enemies spawn from? Oops, floating Lydia. Well, I'll just leave them to deal with that. Well, that's a Stalgard soldier, but let's just kill him. I was kind of uncertain whether I should kill the Stalgard soldier or not. I'm not even looting them. They can go to hell. The only things I'm going to take from these guys is the arrows, really. Oops, I hit the Amber Soldier instead. And you're dead? Good. I'm gonna take the arrows, and that's about it. Yeah, that guy covered, I like it. Dwarven arrows, that's all I'm taking. But this is just a pointless waste of time. We could serve ourselves better than this. Why the hell is Lydia floating? Why? Stop floating, please. Oh, that's better. Come on, Lydia. Run, run. Or are you just going to stand there? Oh, she keeps wanting to float. I think our nav mesh is a bit messed up, but never mind. Let's just rush forward into Stalgard. I like the random catapult shit that just kind of flows across the air, but it's not very realistic if I have to be brutally honest with you. Oh, here comes Lydia now. I don't like why we have to start so far back. I mean, why? Why do we have to start this far back? Oh well. And there should be some enemies coming up now. Ah, there we go. Oops, this cast didn't work. You are going to die to my flames. You're pretty strong. I'm gonna get this out and use it. That was a Stalgard soldier, not as much. No, don't know why I'm bothering to loot. They don't deserve loot. Oh, we've got an amber soldier who's stuck. Oh, nice. I'm just gonna stumble you to get you to die. Wait! I love it when that happens, it's great. Actually, I'll take the elven arrows. I don't know why these guys have such crappy loot on them, but I suppose it's to make sure that we don't come back here enough in this shithole. We're gonna go the long way right here. Those gates are barred up, they'll be open later, but I think this is so stupid, in my opinion, having to go around this long route to get there. I think it's just a force of battle. And we'll just kind of leave them to it. And let's just get in there. It's hard to see who the hell you're supposed to be hitting at this rate. No, you're not going to kill me. I'm going to kill you. No, you're not going to do that. You're going to die. And there's a endlessly barricaded up area there. My health regenerated pretty quickly, I have to say. Lydia's fine, we'll just keep to the back here, come on. Why the hell is Lydia following all these guys for? Alright, here's another bunch of enemies here. Ow, that hurt. Whoever hit me there. Just heal up quickly and get back into the thick of it.
Die, criminal!
Oh shit, this is close. And he's a humanoid. Oh shit. That was close. I could have died. I don't want to replay all of this again. Crap. Graphics don't really lend anything to this, do they? Stumble, thank you, die. And he goes, spinning. I'll take the gold. I don't know, what the hell is with all this built up area? It's so stupid looking. And there's a normal person, for fuck's sake. Bad layout, if anything.
You should have obeyed the law.
Upper. Why the hell am I stuck? That's just crazy. No, I am gonna kill you. No. Oh, got you. Before you could do a death on me. Yeah, I wish you could just stop annoying me and get back to doing your job. And this is going to be Dwarven Arrows I'm taking from you. Don't know why I have to go the long way around, but no, it's a very up and down place, this, I have to say. It's only taken us all this time to get to this point, apparently. I'm actually just going to activate this lever to open the passageway through so we can just get them through quicker. Although this is going to cause a lot more enemies to be involved. And where the hell is all these enemies at? Oh, there's a Khajiit. Oh no, 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 don't! Oh no! Well, fuck! I have been killed. That's not too good. I hope I don't reload before all the battle crap. I think I do. Let me just kind of rush ahead as quickly as I can and get back to that point. And hopefully get to the final little sequence stuff. Because it looks like I'm able to finish Falskar in this part. So I'll try and rush ahead to get to that point again and meet you back there. Right, caught back with this point again. I'm just going to quick save. Bit difficult because for some reason I've lost most of my army for no apparent reason. So don't know if that's a glitch or if really if you reload after dying, basically no one's here. Because like I'm having to fight these with just Ulgar, Lydia, and a couple of flame anchorites, which isn't very helpful in the slightest. Where the hell did that one go? I'm gonna just open this to see if it has any effect at all. I don't think it will, but I don't know, but a couple of people have come through, but pretty much I had a huge army as you saw, but I've pretty much been whittled down to nothing by reloading for no apparent reason. Which makes little sense. Oh, for where the hell did these guys come from? Okay, so basically if you reload or die during this bit, all the soldiers will just stand at a point completely ignoring the enemy. The enemy will ignore them. And then suddenly spawn at this point for no reason at all. Can't explain that at all. A few more enemies left and then we'll be done with it. As sick as all this, just to loop around, says you. Horse is running. I can't really do anything in this, there's no point. I can take down an archer though, I suppose. I'll take down this guy with fire. I think I need to get maybe shock damage or something just to kind of help out. I'm not sure. But we'll see. And everyone else has just turned up here apparently. For any warning possible. But yeah. And then see Stalgard fine. There's a door up ahead, we're gonna head on in and hear the speech before ending this part. Because we've actually been going on for a lot longer than I was expecting, but such is the way of YouTube video making. I'll just quick save before we go in. Yes, keep up the attack, good for it. Wait, anything you're not going to really see. Oh no, you can see stuff.
I'm off to
and
get
I can't
the heart
move. I can't move.
How did you find out where it was?
Oh, well, you helped me out with that one. When I took your wife and kid, I was going to interrogate them to find out. However, on my way there, I got word that you had flocked in to save them. How heroic. With you and your little clan gone out of town, it was easy enough for my thieves to sneak in and get that book.
So basically you didn't know what it was until you had to nick the book.
Not until you were all kind enough to show me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I really must be going.
But we'll stop you, don't worry. Goodbye, Ingvar. Ow! That was quick. Why the hell have I been arrowed already? Just a few elite guards. I'm not even going to bother with this. I like how the quest marker is just pointing there. There shouldn't even be a quest marker. It should just point you up to this door and then remove the quest marker. Oh, here's some more elite guards. I'll just kill these guys off. Oh, destruction's up to 54, how nice. But come on, kill them off, kill them off, kill them off. I don't know why, oh. Shit, I didn't mean to hit Agnar there. Dumb, but never mind. I'm just gonna hold these and despawn those.
The city is wrecked, and his army defeated. His only hope now is to get the heart of the god.
You say so?
We must fight up to the temple of Dominion.
Oh, he's got a lot of blood around his neck. I'm gonna be speed stabbed in the neck. But no. Now we're gonna loot these boys, well, beast. So, final quest, the Heart of the Gods. We'll complete Falskar with me, Mithanian, in the last video. The last video, not the next video, sorry. Because after we're done with Falskar, I'm gonna move back to Skyrim. And it looks like, because I haven't managed to complete the mod in this part, I'm gonna have to do some other stuff off camera or just make the next video really short. Anyway, see you at Mountain Mist Temple. Well, back here, at least in here, to go up to Mountain Mist Temple.